Hi guys, Ian Johnson from DriveSuccess.com. Today we're going to talk about business-to-business sales, cold calling, and specifically we're going to cover five of the most common customer roadblocks or objections that you're going to come across when you do a cold call. Before we get to these five, I just wanted to basically discuss one particular thing. There's two types of cold calls, okay? First of all, there's a warm call, and a warm call is where your marketing has done a good job of getting your message out to the market, okay? So you're basically calling someone who may have never bought from you before, doesn't know you personally, but they know what your company is and they know what your company is about. That's when your marketing has done a good job, okay? A cold call, an extreme cold call, is when you're calling someone who knows nothing about you, nothing about your company, has never bought from you before, and really doesn't know who you are, okay? So these five common stall tactics typically occur when you're calling someone who knows nothing about you, when you're making that extreme cold call. But there's one thing that I want you to take away from today's video. When you're doing a cold call and you're pursuing a high-level executive, a C-level executive, a high-level decision maker, you have to understand that they are using these stall tactics to get you off the phone. But they are looking for the type of salespeople who can handle these stall tactics and still move forward. If it's a vice president of sales that you're calling or a business owner, you know, they're using this stall tactic because they don't have time to talk to you, right? They never have time. It's never a good time. It's always better to call back. But at the end of the day, they want someone like you who's going to acknowledge these five statements that we're going to go over today. And they want you to just move forward. Whether they know it or not, you're the kind of salesperson that they would want or that they once were. So understand that. Don't be intimidated by these five common stall tactics, okay? So let's go over what they are. Number one, I don't have time now. Again, it's never a good time. So acknowledge the statement, fine, I understand you don't have time, I'll be brief. And then go right into your 15-second intro or right into your sales pitch in terms of, hey, Mr. Customer, I understand you're busy. But this is what we've done for a customer in your area or a similar customer who is having these problems, and they achieved about a 30% return on investment, something along those lines, okay? So would that be interesting to you, Mr. Customer? So acknowledge this statement, I don't have time now, I understand, I'll be brief, and then go right into it. Believe me when I tell you that high-level executives, they're using this as a stall tactic. When you acknowledge the statement and just push forward, you may find at the end of the conversation, because it's happened to me, that a C-level executive or a high-level contact is going to say, you know what, I wanted to get off the phone with you, but you were convinced in your argument and you put forth something that made me think and I'm glad you did it, okay? The second one is, I am about to enter a meeting. Now, think about this for a second. Let's say you're calling someone at 1:45. And he's about to enter a meeting. The meeting's not starting at 1:50, it's not starting at 1:55, it's starting at 2. You're calling someone at 1:37, starting at 2. So they're about to enter a meeting. They may be about to enter a meeting in about 23 minutes or 25 minutes. But the fact is that understand when you're calling and understand that this is just a stall tactic. Many times I have actually had someone say, I'm about to enter a meeting, and we've been on the phone for 25, 30 minutes by the end of the discussion. Because I understand you're about to enter a meeting, so I'll be quick, and here it is. If the individual says, I'm in a meeting right now, and you're going to have to call me back, that's different. But someone who says, I'm about to enter a meeting, okay, well, that's something you have to understand. It's just a stall tactic. Look at the time. 1:37, what, you're going into a meeting probably at 2? Don't say that to your customer. What I'm saying is just go into your pitch. Acknowledge the statement, then go into your pitch, okay? The third thing is, can you call back? Okay? You're going to say, yes, I will call back, but before I do, here's some food for thought. Bang, go into it. Acknowledge the statement, yes, but here I want you to think about this so that when I call back, we can have a better discussion. And then go right into it, all right? The fourth thing is, you commonly hear, I'm just about to leave. Okay? They may say, I'm just about to leave for vacation or whatever. But they're just about to leave. So they haven't left yet. Okay, quick, I'll be very blunt and I'll be very quick, and here's what I want you to think about. Mr. Customer, would it be interesting to you if we were able to sell you a product that could help you lower your cycle times in manufacturing by upwards of 15%. Would that be interesting to you? Acknowledge the statement, move right into it, okay? Now the fifth thing you tend to hear is, oh, I've heard about you guys. Okay? Now, you tend to hear that with, you know, someone saying it incredulously, or they're basically being indifferent. Oh, I've heard about you guys. Now, this is not a get off the phone. He's just saying, I've heard about you guys. He probably hasn't heard anything good about you guys. But your job is not to be intimidated by that statement. Be positive and straightforward and upfront and say, good, I'm glad you've heard about us. So you must have heard about how we saved this customer 25% on this. You must have heard about how good a job our product does this, this, or this, because it doesn't rely upon this technology, it relies upon that technology. So acknowledge the statement, oh, I've heard about you guys, and say, oh, good, I'm glad you've heard about us. You must have heard about how we did this, 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 or maybe you read our most recent press release where we were able to save this company 25% on whatever. Acknowledge the statement and go right into it. Now, these are the five most common objections you're going to come across. Again, understand who you're talking to. You're talking to an executive who's using this to get you off the phone. But if you acknowledge a statement and go right into it, they're going to come away impressed. And as I said earlier, it's not uncommon for them to be at the end of the conversation 20 minutes later saying, you know what, I wanted to get off the phone with you. I didn't want to hear it. I didn't want to talk to anybody today about this stuff. But I liked your pitch. I like what you had to say. You've made me think about things, and I think we're going to work together. So these are the five most common objections you're going to come across when you're doing an extreme cold call. Now, I did a video a while back about the most common objections that salespeople create themselves, okay? And these are salespeople that aren't comfortable with cold calling, so they'll invariably say, hi, my name is Ian Johnson. Do you have a couple minutes? No, I don't. Bang, call ends. Is now a good time? No, I don't. No, it's not a good time. Click, call ends. So these are customer objections, but don't create them. Now, a link just popped up above my head for that video. It's basically taken from the mindset of a salesperson who creates these stall tactics or these objections on behalf of the customer because they think they're being polite. Don't make that mistake. Another video that I did that has about 30,000 views talks about how you use your value proposition and your customer's fears and concerns and tie it in with leading questions. That's an excellent video in order to understand how to convey your value proposition to customers. Now, a link just popped up above my head for that video. That's a good one to watch as well. At the end of the day, what you want to understand is that customers never have the time. Acknowledge the statement and go right into your pitch. Go right into what you have to offer. So that's it. Business to business sales, cold calling, customer roadblocks, objections, and stall tactics. Please subscribe to my blog. The link will appear any moment now. And my YouTube channel, please subscribe as well. The link is at the bottom, DYS. There's a little emblem at the bottom of the video. So that's it. Ian Johnson, drivesuccess.com. Bye-bye.